Hi everyone, I'm Henry from Excellent Analytics. This is an example of reusable automated linear and average forecasting tool that can handle multiple items using just an Excel. This is done and calculated by just using your existing Microsoft Excel software version 2016 or above using Power Pivot Table, DAX, Power Query, without using VBA to do the task of calculation. There is no need to be a top-notch programmer to complete this setup. As long as you have a basic knowledge in Excel, a bit knowledge in linear regression and enterprise resource planning, or ERP, then just follow through this instructional video, you are good to go. The results created by the forecasting tool in this Excel can also be uploaded or imported from Excel to the most commonly ERP software out there, such as SAP and Oracle. I will demonstrate the procedure in setting up your Excel similar like this. For now, this full tutorial comprises of three parts of short videos only. This part one video is dedicated to give you walkthrough on how this can be used to quickly give you insights without the need to use SQL or alternative software to do the query. The outcome of forecasted items is in batch data, therefore faster forecasting in just one shot if you're after the linear trend forecasting method. The part 2 video will take care on how to set up auto connection to the source data and combine multiple workbooks or data sheets to make this Excel a reusable file as often as you want, even though you relocate the directory or location of this file to the other folders or share to your colleague at work or home. Part 3 video is about shaping your data with charts and tables to be more readable by user and using built-in formula from Excel. If you're in a hurry to set up your own, just copy and paste of formula we're going to produce is just fine. And also in part 3 video, shaping the table to be read by ERP software when you finish forecasting. This setup can handle large amount of data depending on the speed and capacity of your computer. Since this setup uses connection method only, meaning it doesn't hold or store data, even though there are gigabytes in total of combined source data. Still, this is depending on the speed of your computer. But you know, in reality, even though most commonly known ERP software out there also struggles and takes time to import or export large amount of data set to be shared to another ERP software. This example I created has customer's name I randomly pick up from Wikipedia and the imaginary items product description, but the number and the patterns are based in real-world situation so that the trend is meaningful enough to give insights and prediction trend. It is so arranged in this manner of common standard supply chain data comprises of location such as the state, city, material number and description, completed orders, work in process orders, dates, prices. The data is summarized and aggregated into monthly or yearly manner from numerous daily transactions. So here are the examples you can get insight by querying the summarized data.
So first question is how to sort out in descending order and show the top states volume runner for the last 3 years. So let's begin from year 2019 by trimming this date beginning January 2019 until mid 2021. Then right click in this under this column grand total anywhere within this column, then sort out from largest to smallest. So here are the top states: California, Florida, New York, and so on. So let's answer the second question. is how to sort out in descending order and show the top states volume runner last year 2020. Just click this anywhere in this column year 2020, right click, sort out largest to smallest, and there you go. Nothing much changed, but Rhode Island, Texas is has some changes. So let's go to third question, which is how to sort descending order and show the top customer volume orders. So these are the volume orders, of course. Then just replace this first column by clicking this show field list and interchange or swap customer this state, then right click, collapse the entire field so that only customer should appear in this column. And here are the top customer: Valero, Alphabet, Amazon, and so on. Fourth question is how to show the volume trend of California state with all its customers and product line and compare it to Florida state. Just click this slicer, California, then also the Florida. So here is the result. So California has more volume orders than Florida. Sixth question is how to show the current year top item volume runner. So this is a top item. It means looks for a material or description. So what we are looking for is the current year top item volume runner. Volume runner is still the total orders, which is just right click anywhere across this every total orders quantity, then sort largest to smallest, and there you go. Here are the top orders arranged descending order from largest to smallest. Seventh question is how to show the current year, which is year 2021. In this case, current year 2021 top increasing demand. Top increasing demand is actually this slope. So the higher the slope, or if the slope is positive, it means it has an increasing trend. If it is negative, decreasing trend. So let's arrange this by sorting largest to smallest, and here it is. If I'm going to filter this certain amount of quantity, then keep only selected items, here is the result. By the way, you notice that these green arrows and red arrows downward will just show if the items is below 255. You can also expand the trend of year 2021, and you will notice that this certain product and so on are increasing. So what does it mean is that this slope, that for every month there is a average of increased 2923 orders or units. Okay, the reason why this grand total is a downward trend across beginning 2019 until 2021, even though you have a upward or increasing trend, because this is the overall trend beginning 2019-2021. I will show this to you by keep only selected this item. Then if I select Florida alone, you've noticed that this trend is in downward overall, but yearly is going up, then second year is going down, then go up. If I'm going to draw a trend line, you will notice that this trend line here is declining beginning 2019, because this is the overall. So moving forward, the ninth question is how to sort in descending order and show the product's volume runner ordered by state of California and Florida. Click California and hold down Ctrl key, and also click the Florida state. So it's asking for year 2019 until present. Here are the volume runner and the trend here. 10th question, project or predict the all product volume orders of North Carolina alone. Here, click the North Carolina, then let's project this year 2021 until December by moving this date till December. So here is the projected volume orders, and the numbers are actually here, just down here. If you want to expand, just expand it, and here are the numbers. Just look this total linear trend. So it is actually declining a bit by 38 units per month. 11th question is quickly show and filter the first top six of product quantity ordered between year 2019 until year 2021 for all states. Let's remove all the filters under the state slicer, then sort this out in this grand total column and filter the top six by highlighting the first six here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There you are. Then right click, click filter, then keep only selected item. Here you go. Here are the top six of product items. Filter this per state, it will show the result of the trend of this top six. And also here are the sort out state. So top one is California, next is New York, Rhode Island, Florida, and so on for overall 3 years, past 3 years. Now I have one reserved question. How to show the top intermittent orders of product in a span of 4 years? So 4 years, what does it mean? Let's start beginning 2018, then until mid of 2021 only. So what does this intermittent orders mean is that there is no continuous demand every month. So like for example, this is a product A437. You've noticed that there is no orders on this particular month. No. So how to find and sort out all these products for the last 4 years? So this is how it is being done. Let's remove all the filters first. Then I prepared some one formula here. What the this is a monthly continuous orders to identify which product has a continuous orders. Then what I'm gonna do is I will sort these monthly continuous orders from smallest to largest. And here you go. So if I'm going to keep these first few samples, and, then sort this one from largest to smallest, then you will notice that these are the orders. Okay, as for average trend forecast, it is self-explanatory that every year the total order is being averaged, as you notice here in this chart. So you can do this similar way by sorting this average trend to see which are the orders has a higher volume ordered by California State and New York, for an example. And you can get this top few items by filter tip only selected items, and you will able to see the trend every month. So mostly as declining orders. So stay tuned for part 2 and part 3 video to show how this can be set up into your Microsoft Excel.